Man, this dude, man, very funny, man. Like, I never really meet him either, but I met him tonight. His name is Cool Ass Mike.
Hey.
Give it up for him. Give it up for him.
All right, all right, all right, all right. How's everybody doing tonight?
Good.
What's up? This is Jim being here.
Hey.
A little intermission music like that.
Good night.
He was looking for you earlier, though. He was like, where my DJ at, though? I can't get up there on no DJ. Man, this is great to be here right now.
Yeah.
I love these small, intimate environments, you know what I'm saying? A good range of folks. I was on my way here tonight. First of all, I'm from New York. Anybody here from, not from LA?
Yeah.
That's our host. So one thing I've realized about folks who are not from here is we hustlers. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna do the small rooms. We're gonna show up and do what it takes. Because, you know, we out here trying to pursue that dream. Even though I didn't really come here to pursue a dream, I'm going to pursue it anyway. I came out here from New York originally because my dad moved out here. He came out here like in the 70s, you know, he became a Black Panther. Anybody here from the 70s and the 60s signed on the Black Karate Federation and all those guys? Oh yeah. So my pops used to roll with them, right? When the Panther back in New York came out here, was like, he went to the Marines, he got disenfranchised, like, listen, I need to keep fighting a big fight. So he came out here and got with the BKF. And so he brought me out here when I was younger, and I know going back and forth between here in New York, it always gave me like a different perspective of life. You know what I'm saying? I'd be back there, everybody got there thugging and, you know, doing graffiti, breakdancing and stealing stuff. And then I come out here and it was gangbang.
Right.
And so, you know, you were talking about earlier how you first came out here, right? I gotta tell y'all the story about when I first got here. So my dad always lived pretty much in Englewood, right? Y'all know Englewood, right? You probably around the corner and shit. So I came out here, right, the wood. So I came out here for eighth grade, and so when I first came out here, so, speaking to the gang specifically, so Englewood is a blood neighborhood. It's red, in and out, Englewood. Well, I don't know about nowadays, but I mean, some kids now, back then it was all red. So before I left New York, first of all, I'm not getting into the dirt I was getting into, but I had this dope-ass blue Bugle Boy top to bottom outfit. Yo, I was doing my thing. It matched the whole night of the year. I had some ballet shoes too. Yo. So I went to Monroe. I know Monroe.
Yeah.
I bought my Crenshaw.
Yeah.
What happened that? So I showed up, right? First day, I go out to PE. And I'm like, yo, you know, where's the class at? And they're like, what's up, bro? I'm like, yo, what's up, man? And so where's the PE class? They're like, nah, what up, bro? I'm like, and, you know, whatever, dog. So, after a while, they're like, yo, but they get in the locker room. Like, yo, what up, blood? I'm like, what? Nigga, what? They're like, nah, homie. Man, we get outside. Crenshaw Mafia. We on Crenshaw right now. Yeah, y'all know. Yep, TMG's is deep. Man, my first day in school, I ain't get into a fight with four motherfuckers out there. I got two of them, though. I got two of them. They remember my name. I still got marks on my knuckles right now from the teeth from that fool. But you know, I stood my ground and I was able to maintain, but I never wore that outfit again. Oh man, I was loving it. I was so excited to be wearing it. Like, yo, it's gonna be hot, son. You know, first day of school.
Yeah.
I was all out, like, man, they gonna love this shit. And I didn't even know, like, you know, the geography and nothing like that. I was just happy to be here. So I was like, okay, you got me. But that never happened again, because then I became a kid from New York though. Yeah, you see what I'm saying? It's a whole new identity. So the good thing about that was I didn't have to really join a gang. Until I went to jail. So I got in New York because I was getting in trouble out there, right? And my grandparents were like, you cannot handle your ass anymore. My pops were like, send his monkey ass out here. I got him. So I literally got arrested right up here on 77th and Crenshaw. Yeah, now let me tell you this story. It's crazy as fuck. So before, it's funny, though, I went through the whole juvenile child system here in California. So first, when I first started fucking up, I accidentally shot my neighbor in the cheek with a BB gun. It was an accident. We were just playing, like, you know, the pump ones. And I was like, pink, what do you cheat? Oh, shit. He goes home, tells his parents. They come to the house later, you know, your son shot our son. He in the Jeep. Man, he went, I mean, that's one of the worst ass whoopers I've ever had in my life. I'm talking blood drawn, I'm up on the refrigerator. It was like, yo, she got dark. So then I ended up in McLaren Hall. Y'all know about McLaren Hall? See, McLaren Hall was where you went when you was taken out of the house because your parents were whooping your ass, but you didn't get in trouble yet. Right. It's no, they just closed it. They gonna be in trouble right when you go over this, right? So, I'm going to get you straight right now, I got arrested. So, when they take me out the house, they said, we're going to put you in foster homes. So I get put in this foster home out in the valley, out in Woodland Hills, ironically where I live at right now. And so, when I was in New York, we used to steal cars, and motorcycles and shit like that, because that's the fucking thing when growing up, the rite of passage, you know, how to break an ignition, all that kind of stuff. So, I go to the mall with my girlfriend at the time. And they like, go to drop me off at the crib, right? So I'm like, yeah, you know, you can drop me off here. But they couldn't make this U-turn. I said, you know what? Just drop me off here in the corner, and I'm going to walk back to the house. Well, at the time, there was a Woodland Hills Nissan on Winnetka and Ventura near Taft High School, where I went to school. So when they drive me off, right, at the time, this is the year the 240 SX first came. I'm 50, by the way. So, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I got to represent all of us here. So this is back in like 86 or some shit like that. Brand new 240SX sitting on the corner. I'm like, girl, what the fuck is that? So I go to the car, like, damn, this shit's hot, son. Open the door, like, woo, look at this thing. Keys in the visor. They just took out the trunk. They were waiting to put it onto the lock. And I'm like, oh, shit. All right, I'm going to take these keys. And if the car is still here later tonight, sidewalk part, like it should not be there. And I'm like, fuck it, you know, if it's there, then I'm gonna come back. So I go back. Oh, and it's there. And so for that whole summer, I'm driving around in a brand new 240 SX. The whole summer. I wasn't knowing at the time. I'll get into all my friends came a white male another time, but I really thought that the world was gonna be on my side. So, and this is no joke. So one night with my homie, we both went to Inglewood, but both lived in the valley. So we like those come back down to Sunday on Crenshaw.
Oh yeah.
You already know. So it's late. Things died down a little bit. So we over here by the bowling alley. Oh, while we're girls here now. We got both of chill and shit. I'm like, hey, man, you got a new car and shit. It's still like, yo, what up? So we parked behind the social security building, right? No, like we was so proud in the front. Like we was gonna park and go over there and go, you know, pick up some bitches and shit. So we stand over here, like, yeah, you know, what's up, yeah. And these fools over here, you know, doing their thug pism and shit. And next thing you know, you're like, what? Like, huh, these niggas and shit. You gotta keep an eye on them. Nigga, what are you? Like, you're like, oh shit. And we behind the dude that's shooting at. Which means, right. So they're right in the building, right? Like, oh, man, get to the car. And then we race another pressure on. Because you know, on Sunday, you got to roll, right? Yeah. We jam it, right? Get up to Hyde Park in Crenshaw. Now, I'm in the leftmost lane. These girls were hollering at me in the right lane. But they were like 2-3 cars back. And they were supposed to go to the party to meet up and hook up with them, right? So we're like, yo, talking shit. Everybody in Crenshaw doing the Crenshaw thing. And I see their blinker on. I'm like, oh shit, they're about to make a right. Don't trip. I'll make a right and I'll pull over and wait for him. I'm in the front. It's a red light for us. 3 lanes. You know Crenshaw, 3 lanes. So when I see them put the right blinker on, I'm like, man, fuck that shit. I'm 16. You know, I don't know consequences. So I bust a right across all the traffic. And I was gonna pull over and wait for them to get right. They didn't do that. They went straight. I'm like, man, this is not a bitch. So I hit the first block, jam up that street. Left on either 67, right back on Crenshaw. And yo, that we passed with the officer. Yo, what's up, what the fuck is that? You try to hit up the hill. Whoop, whoop. I'm like, oh shit. I ain't got no stolen car, no registration, no. I got the keys. I ain't got no screws out, so I'm thinking I can talk around this. So second we get out the car, again, we move to the valley because that's where the foster home was at, right? Now, I know you just got, you're not from here, so I'm bringing to an accent for you. I'm like, what are you doing right now? But this is the valley thing, right? So we get out the car. I'm like, oh, dude, what the fuck, bro? Like, homeboy get in the car, man. This shit didn't even know first, man. He's fucking, he's at the house. His name's out of town. We're sitting for a time. Like, oh, what the fuck, man? Like, I'm like, oh, man, that's crazy. You know that hotel, like, was 78 or some shit like that in Crenshaw?
Yeah.
We sit on that little wall on the side. We sit there. And so that's what happened. So he's like, oh, okay, yeah, just go ahead and have a seat, all right? And we sit, I'm like, dude, shut the fuck up. He's more of like a, he is mixed. So he had one, he was in the valley, like, you can play it better, just shut the fuck up. So we sitting there, helicopter circling. I'm like, damn, y'all are hella deep on this little stolen car. They're like, yeah. So the helicopter saw you make that right turn, and then jam up the fucking street. They thought you was about to go shoot somebody.
Oh.
I was like, oh, shit. Okay, my bad, it wasn't even like that.
Right.
Man, it took us to the 77th Division.
Quick.
Yo. So we get there, right? Now, this is my first time in jail in California. So I'm like, okay, this is all crazy. Yeah, in New York, it's completely different. I just know what the fuck I got to deal with. But here, as they take us into the cells, there's a dicky seat, a captain seat up on the wall with a blue rag, and I forgot what the hat was. And I'm in my cane. He was like, yeah, that's one of the OG whoopie whoopie whoop. That nigga ain't here no more. So don't get your ass in the cell. I was like, oh my God. So I'm tripping. I'm like, yo, what the fuck am I gonna do right now? I'm in fucking jail in LA. This is crazy. They take me to LP. Y'all know those Pacinos?
Yeah.
So that's when you graduate from McLaren Hall. You done committed a crime. Yeah, now you go to LP. Huh. I'm gonna wrap this up. My first night at LP, man, I would have never done any more dirt if they would have let me go the next morning, because that night, I get there. You seem a little too old to be in my age range. Homeboy at the bar, he might know what I'm talking about. But when you get to LP, so they have the orientation going, and then they got the first room you go into, and I'm like, you gotta be here for a minute. They put me right into CD. Now, if you know, CD is where all the thug niggas was at. All the biggest ones. So, and I get in there at 10 o'clock at night. Maybe even 11 o'clock at night. I mean, because they couldn't keep me in the prison state overnight. So they took me to LP that fucking night. So I get there. I'm like, okay, this is not that bad. It seems relatively quiet right now. Everyone's like in the dorms and shit. The dorms like, you know, county, whatever, the cells and shit. So I get into the dorm, like probably like six, seven rooms down the hallway. Man, as soon as they close that door, all you hear is, sex jerks and shit.
How?
I mean, because I know I'm 16, 17? I mean, once I graduated from county, that shit was done. Yeah, by the time I got to county, there was no more sex or shit. But because I was in a group home in Englewood, and we was fighting the posers and shit like that, and all that shit. Right. So, you know what I'm saying? And what it was, the reason why I got with homeboy, because I didn't want to be a butter crit. I was way too committed. I'm down, but I'm not that fucking down.
That's right.
But I had a homeboy who was a jerk, and he was a cool motherfucker, so I was like, yo.
You said about the house.
Who?
A house.
Yeah. But the ones that like the posers and shit, they was in the dance and shit. Yeah, I was in
New York. You should have been
at Houses. Right. Where was they at? I don't remember them. Where was they at?
I'm older than you.
I'm 50.
I can't count.
Oh, okay. So you put the junior high. I didn't want my name. Hey, get your ass back for the campus.
I can't count.
Anyway, hey, I appreciate y'all listening to me. This is going to be hella fun. My name is Kuma. That's Mike.